Hi guys, Alicia and Linda here from Locations Estate Agents Gladstone. We're going to do a little thing here, a bit funny, maybe a bit quirky, getting to know the both of us. So we're going to run through a couple of quick questions and hopefully you'll get to know a bit more about Linda and I and have a bit of a laugh at the same time, because no doubt it's going to be quite comical. So Linda, what do you love about living in Gladstone?
Well, I've lived here for my whole life. My dad was actually born here as well, so we've got a few generations here. I don't know, it's home. I do enjoy going to, you know, Brisbane, you know, the city kind of lifestyle, but it's nice to come home, a bit more relaxed back here.
Yeah, I agree. I love Gladstone because it's a port city. We are not a mining town, what people think. We're not sort of out west somewhere. We have reef, beaches right here on our doorstep. It's very family friendly. Plenty of stuff going on for Gladstone, and I think there's going to be a lot of prosperity in the future too. So what do you think would be one thing that people would be surprised to know about you?
Well, I started working at McDonald's, so that was my first job, and I was actually there for about 8 years, and I actually worked my way up from crew person up to store manager, so yeah.
Yeah, wow, okay. And one fun thing people would know about me,
crazy cat.
Yeah, we'll go with that. That's probably the nicest thing I could think of just now. Bucket list. What are you looking at doing? What's a big ticket item for Linda Smith?
I'd eventually love to do a bit more travel, probably after we've had kids. I'd like to go to America and Europe one day.
Disneyland maybe?
Yeah, that'd be fun.
Yeah, I think a bucket list item for me, it's a little bit, I guess, cliche, but Machu Picchu. You know, that little Inca type area, probably not even Incas, but I like it. It's mountainous, looks amazing, so I want to go there. Cool. Favourite food? Starts with?
This is a really hard
one.
This is a really hard one. I have a sweet tooth, so it's really hard to pinpoint one sweet food that I love, but probably I love sweet potato. It's very versatile.
Oh, I actually, that is not a lie. She just, if there's sweet potato chips on a menu, Linda is all over it.
All over it.
A really depressing undertone when they say, oh, we've run out of sweet potato chips.
Obviously,
mine is chocolate and champagne. So two C's, everything with a C. Okay, favourite interior design trends. What are you thinking this year?
Well, there is a few good ones that have come up. So it's really hard to pinpoint one. I like... a little note here, it's really hard. Mid-century modern look.
Had to Google that.
Yeah, I was like, what is it
Wikipedia
called?
Wikipedia, what does that mean?
Yeah.
Seen it, just don't know how to describe
it. That's it.
Yeah, what's my favourite trend? I'm not really a trend person, I'm definitely a minimalist. So anything, clean lines, streamlined kitchens, Michael will know exactly what that means. Actually, hashtag streamlined kitchens, because I'm pretty sure that is going to be trending in 2017. Check it out. Michael Burns, watch him. Okay, and what do we like to do on days off? Days off. Well, the last time I had a day off, I think I went to a wedding. But in all seriousness, I think just quiet time. When you're dealing with people 24/7, you're engaged, social media, phone, public, everything, it's nice just to chill out at home.
Definitely, and catch up on the housework that gets neglected.
Yeah, Zach, what are you doing, mate? Slacking off there. I'll just skip a couple of these because we have been talking for a little while. I'm definitely a coffee person. Linda, you're a...
I'm a hot chocolate person.
No, there's no judging.
No coffee or tea, really.
And if you had to have dinner with one person, who would it be?
This is a tricky one, but probably Corey Parker.
Corey Parker, if you're watching. We have a serial stalker.
No! I wouldn't go that far, but...
No, like just face stalking. If I had to have dinner with one person, oh gosh, that's a tricky one. Of course, yours truly, Jolly, I have to say that. I know he gets an honourable mention.
I'll put Zach on there too, but you know.
second tier. But if I had to go for one person, I don't know. Maybe Mark Boris, actually. He's probably a secret business crush that I have. He's a really... a skilled entrepreneur, and I have a lot of time and respect for what he has to say. So one final question. If you could jump on a plane right now, where would you go?
Oh my goodness.
Tick, tick,
I don't really know. There's too many places to...
I'm going to say Sydney. I really enjoyed Sydney the last time I was down there. plenty of cool things to go see, do. I've been to Brisbane plenty of times. Haven't really got to Melbourne, Sydney before. Would also like to go to Perth. But I'd like to go to Sydney again, see some of my friends down there. Manly Wharf is amazing on a Friday, just have to say. Have you thought of anything yet?
Canberra. Well, I'm booked to go to Canberra later in the year, so bringing it forward would be nice. Go see my sister.
Lovely. All right, well, thanks for sharing, Linda.
Thank you.
And I hope you've got to know a little bit more about us crazy cat people here at locations. We'll speak to you soon.
Thanks.